Welcome, welcome, welcome. Hello, hello, hello to each and every one of you awesome people. And you know what? I just thought that I would want to share something super important with you in these short videos that I create for yourself. So hey, everybody, I'm Pallavi Kalia Raj. And yes, I definitely am one of India's premier charismatic communication coaches. And today I just felt like sharing with you a few pointers on this one particular question that I keep getting a lot of times from people, which is that, Pallavi, please tell us, how do we improve our English? Okay, how do we improve our vocabulary? How do we improve our pronunciations? All of that. So if you are ready to get those very, very simple pointers from me, just understand this, that this is not like an overnight game. This isn't like a 15-day hack or a 1-month hack. This is a little bit of a long-term game, because anything related to communication obviously involves you breaking those old habits and forming new habits and then really getting awesome, super awesome at whatever it is that you start doing. So one of the areas that you can really start progressing really well in is your habit of reading. Okay, now I know for a fact that not a lot of you are continuous readers, not a lot of you are readers at all. Okay, so if you definitely want to improve your English, there is a way to do so, and it's a very scientifically proven kind of a way. When you start reading more content, not watching first and foremost, watching will come later, but when you start reading more English content, then automatically what will start happening is you will start, your brain will start understanding those words, understanding how those sentences are framed, understanding, okay, this is what I can use after this. So a lot of, I'll give you a simple example. A lot of times people say, I couldn't cope up with the situation. Cope up is not English at all. I don't know which language it is, but it is not English. Okay. So when you're used, when you want to use cope in the English language, you have to use just cope. I couldn't cope with the situation. Got it? No cope up. Now this, either you listen to people carefully when they're saying this, or you watch this kind of a video and you understand it. But there are so many other aspects, right? Like people say, I didn't knew. Now, in an English content, written content, it will never be written like this, I didn't knew. It will always be written as I didn't know, because didn't is already the past tense. You can't use past tense plus past tense, okay? So I didn't know will be written there in a particular book or in an article or whatever it is that you're reading, right? So therefore, I tell you that when you get into the habit of reading and start with maybe just 15 minutes a day, if you're not a reader at all, if you've been a fairly okay reader and you've been reading, let's say for about 15, 20 minutes a day, increase it to maybe about 35 to 45 minutes a day. If you've been reading for about half an hour or 40 minutes a day, then increase it maybe to 1 hour a day, because every single minute you put into reading in a particular language, you are definitely getting in a lot of new vocabulary. You are learning the way sentences are framed. You are learning grammatically correct English, if English is what you're reading. And you're also learning how, you know, when it's written, let's say something is written in a humorous vein, you will understand, oh, okay, this kind of a sentence can be used to add in humor. Or let's say something has been said in or written in a very, very emotional kind of a tone. Yes, even written words have a tone. You will be able to understand, oh, all right, this is also a way that I can say it. Okay, so very, very good practice to be able to read a few pages, time yourself. 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, 35 minutes, 45 minutes, 1 hour, fantastic. Okay, that's how you need to be able to read on a daily basis. Now, the other aspect here is that I would really like you people to also start watching, don't watch like just trashy movies all the time. There are some movies which are great, watch them. And also to get into the habit of maybe watching some documentaries on any of these OTT platforms. Maybe for the first 15 days, watch them with subtitles, but don't focus only on the subtitles. Okay, so also watch on how people are pronouncing those words and stuff like that. Okay, one thing in which I forgot, when you're reading, if you don't understand a particular word, yes, of course, go to Google Dictionary. There you will understand the meaning of the word as well. And you will also, if you are able to play the audio pronunciation of the word, you will understand how to pronounce that word as well. Got that? Super hack, right? Okay. Now, the next thing is I was talking to you about watching some of these documentaries. Please go ahead and watch these because these are so powerful. First 15 days with subtitles on the entire duration. Next 15 days, watch it. Suppose it's a half an hour thing, 10 minutes subtitles on, 20 minutes without subtitles. So see whether you're able to understand that particular language without subtitles. Subtitles really ruin everything for us, okay? They don't allow us to really see the emotions. They don't allow us to see people's body language. We are just focused on reading the words, okay? So please try and get into that habit. And third, very, very important aspect of you being able to become a better conversationalist in English or having better vocabulary is that you start speaking the language. So if you don't have people at home who you can speak the language with, tell your friends, ask your friends, hey, listen, you know what? I need some help here. I'm going to start talking in English and I need you to respond in English. Even if by mistake, if you respond in Hindi or whichever other language, I'm going to still continue talking in English. So please get the hint and start speaking to me in English. You might have certain friends who, of course, are very, very good at English. So then go right ahead and start speaking to those people. And in fact, tell those people just in case I make some mistakes, grammatical mistakes, pronunciation mistakes, or, you know, I'm not confident enough, just help me boost my confidence a little bit and hear me out because I really want to be able to improve my English. And this is what Pallavi actually said. And they say, who, Pallavi? Give her the link of my FB private group to follow. Right? Fantastic. And of course, the fourth and the most important hack, if you really want to be able to improve on any aspect of communication, become a charismatic, effective, how would you call it? You know, that kind of a communicator who really connects with people and touches people's hearts and then really goes out there and makes that massive impact in the world. Of course, you need to get in touch with me, and I'm going to give you one link in the particular in this video's description. Go ahead and click on that link and register for my free 90 minutes charismatic communication heart to heart, where I will share with you those three secrets, my steps in order for you to start becoming a lot more charismatic, a lot more effective, powerful, empathetic as a communicator. All right. If you found this video useful, please leave your comments in the comment box, and I shall see you very, very soon. Ciao.